I am from Dallas, Texas, and I grew up in a Christian home and an environment where we are always at church. I thought everybody went to church really early and stayed really late. Like, I just kind of all I knew growing up, and just fell in love with music and watching what happened in people's lives when we would do music at church and God's presence would come. And people that were broken started getting healed and just set free, and realizing that God will draw you through worship music and through us just surrendering our lives to Him. And I just thought, you know, I've got to be a part of this for the rest of my life. I love watching people get touched and ministered through music. And once I learned I could sing, I just thought, this is a given. This is what I want to do with the rest of my life. So here we are today, 30 years later, just trucking along. My dad was a youth pastor at my church, actually, and did a lot of the youth worship, and so I got to get involved with the worship team there. And as I went off to college, I did the same thing, got involved at Oral Roberts University in their worship team. Then I went up to Christ for the Nations, did the same thing, and then just got real involved with my church. And I've just always been a church girl. I've always loved the house of God, and enjoyed watching people get ministered to. So took lessons like any normal singer would, and just grew up singing in choir and trying to make myself better at my craft. When you sing a lot, you get stronger, so you get better at singing. And my songwriting has gotten a lot stronger in the last couple of years. Just the opportunities that I've had to just like co-write with people have made me a stronger songwriter. And realizing that it is part of my calling, part of the DNA of what I need to be doing, has made me do it more. So I feel like the songs I've been writing in the last couple of years have been stronger and just more real. You know, I'm learning kind of more how to just pour out what I'm going through into my music. And that really connects with people, and it's good to do that if you're gonna be ministering to people, you know. On the first record, I wrote with Chris Tomlin and Ed Cash and Mia Field from Hillsong, and just some great worship writers. In this new project, I'm with EMI Sparrow Records now, and so we had to kind of be geared more for radio this time around. And so there's some amazing songwriters in Nashville that I got to work with. Ben Glover, he's a great songwriter. I also wrote with Ed Cash again, and Matt Brownleway, and Jason Ingram. He's one of my favorite people to write with, because he's such a church-minded guy. He loves to sit down and write songs for the church, and they work. So that's one desire, is that song. Great people, though, that just love God and love radio and love to help people through music. I enjoy it. I'm having the time of my life.